Hey, this is Renault, and this is a quick introduction to this very simple hairbrush. So the brush currently has only two sets of two hair strands, and as you can see, the topology is pretty simple and straightforward. For both the left and right set, you'll get a tight and a white variation. And these variations simply refer to where the change of plane actually happens on each strand. The tighter one will have it pretty close to the edge, and the wider one will be slightly more centered, as you can see in the example here. The strand itself is shaped a little bit like a leaf, which not only tapers at the end, but also at the root. And the thing I like about the root tapering is that it allows me to get really elegant and flowing clamping shapes at the top, which is a principle I try to apply in most of the hair I work on, really. One thing I like to do with these is to disable the snapping option and modify the picker behavior, just in cases where I want a strand that I can freely draw on the viewport, you know. And the cool thing is, because these have the curve start option locked, you can relatively easily play with the spline to get nice and smooth shapes while maintaining their position, which is super useful for stuff like flyaways and slightly crazier hairstyle. Another important thing for me when I work with 3D hair strands is to make sure that they're interesting and appealing from every angle. And that includes the bottom of the strand as well, which I feel is very often overlooked and can look pretty flat. So I made sure that this brush would have, you know, that cool asymmetrical thickness built in, which helps a lot, in my opinion, with those underlying connections to make them look deliberate and a little bit more appealing. And lastly, I just wanted to go back to something I mentioned earlier around the fact that these strands have a pretty straightforward topology, which should hopefully allow you to fine-tune their shape to your liking and even modify the topology if you want to. Anyways, I hope this video was somewhat useful. I'm also already planning on adding a few strand variations that I have in mind, so stay tuned for that. And in the meantime, if you have any feedback or comments, don't hesitate to reach out. Happy sculpting, and thanks for watching.